Hey everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is André Kröger from Dagubi. Today I would like to show you how to draw with real vector watercolor brushes, flowers and leaves, and the final image include all brushes I use in this image are available on my website dagubi.com. Create a new document. I use 340mm by 210mm and I use color mode RGB. In today's tutorial, I'm going to use watercolor brushes. These watercolor brushes are available on my website dagubi.com and you will find the link below in the description. So I use paintbrush tool. So first make a double click, check the options. I use this position. So I start with one of these brushes, so for example this, and first I'm going to create a line. So now I'd like to change the width profile. So I'm going to use the width profile and first choose the width profile tool. So next zoom in, I use Control and the spacebar to zoom. So I start with the width tool on this position, click and drag your mouse. Next, for example here. And on the first position. So if you like, you can move these lines, click and drag the line. So that's fine. Next, I'm going to save this width profile, go to the toolbar on top and click on this button, add to profiles. So delete this line and now I'm going to change the color to red. And now start with the paintbrush tool. If you like to draw with the same width profile and another brush, please hold the Alt key to pick another brush. And now again, hold the Alt key to pick another brush, draw a line. If you like to move this line, hold the Control key, click and drag your mouse. And now to deselect, hold again the Control key and click on your artboard. And now hold the Alt key to pick a new brush. Rotate it a little bit and again with the Alt key. So now I'm going to change the blending mode. Select all, hold the Control key and select all. Now open the transparency panel and click on blending modes and choose darken. So if you like, you can move leaves again. So like this. So next, I'm going to create this new width profile. So first, choose another brush and use first the same width profile. Now draw a line. Oh, sorry. Now choose the width profile, tool, zoom in, and now going to this point and change it a little bit, and the first point and the last point. And now create a new profile. Oh, sorry. Choose the selection tool, select this line, and click on this button, add to profiles. So delete this and continue with the paintbrush tool. So this time change the blending mode to multiply. And you can change the color a little bit, make it a little bit darker. Sorry. So next, if you like, you can change the stroke width. So choose the selection tool, select the lines, and if you like to change the stroke width in very small steps, hold the control key and click on the small arrows. Okay, next I'm going to use another brush set, so I use the splashes and I try this brush and yellow color. So now go to the toolbar on the left side and click on this button, draw behind. Draw a line. So you can open the layers panel. So this is my new line. Select the line and scale it a little bit. Oh, sorry. Select, and you can use your arrow keys on your keyboard. So that's fine. Next, choose another brush. So for example, this brush, and change the color to orange and change the blending mode to multiply. So, but like to arrange this, so move layer on top and scale it a little bit. So that's fine. So next, change the color to yellow. Blending mode darken and again, the stamp and washes brushes. So, and this time without wood profile, change stroke width to 1.5. And another brush. Like to change the stroke width of some of these brushes. So select the line and hold the control key and click on the small arrows. That's fine. And this line. And I'd like to change the width profile by this brush. So open the width profile window and click on the next profile. So that's fine. So next, please change the color, make it to dark red. And now change the blending mode to multiply and change the drawing mode. Go to the toolbar on the left side and click on draw normal. Change the stroke width to 0.5. So I'd like to change this brush, zoom in, so next I'd like to draw with small dots, so I use red color and blending mode multiply and one of these brushes, so a little bit darker, and stroke width 1 point. So that's fine. So I'd like to move all a little bit down, select all and use your arrow keys. So hold the shift key to move it in very big steps. So that's fine. And I like to change the color of my last strokes. So select, hold the control key. And again, the small dots. And I like to scale it. So for proportional scale, you can check the options. Open the transform panel and check scale strokes and effects. Next, I'm going to use the short strokes. I use this type of brushes. So I start with this brush and green color. Set the blending mode to darken. And change the stroke width to very thin. change a little bit color. That's fine. And with another brush, for example, this, create a second line. And change the stroke white. So I continue with this type of brushes. Change the color to orange. And I'm going to use width profile. So this width profile include in Illustrator. So change the stroke width to 0.5 or 6. And now hold the Alt key and pick another brush. And the third brush. And now again on the left side. So change the color to red, like this. And I'm going to use my stamp and washes. So delete and start again with new color. And another brush, so I think with this brush. So that's fine. And now I'm going to draw leaves with green color. So I try this green color. If you like to pick this color, hold the Control key and select this line. Now you have this green color. So I start with this brush. And now change the width profile. This default Illustrator width profile. Change the blending mode to darken. And change the stroke width. And continue with another brush. Every time hold the Alt key to use the same width profile. And again, change the stroke width 0.5. So next, change the color, make it a little bit darker. And change the blending mode to multiply. And again with the same width profile. So you can change the stroke width. So, by the way, I draw everything with the mouse. So, I'd like to draw with this color. And the same stroke width and the same width profile. So hold the control key and select this line. And Illustrator change color and get the same width profile. And now change the brush and draw a big leaf here. And here. So now change again the color, make it a little bit darker. And continue with the brushes, change the stroke width. Sorry. So and last with very dark green. So this time you can use the same brush, for example this, and blending mode multiply. And I like to change stroke width by some of these leaves. Hold the control key to select the lines. So next I'd like to make some corrections. I'd like to scale some of the leaves. So choose the group selection tool. And I try with this leaves, select all. And now I recommend you to use the free transform tool to scale the leaves. So it's important to change the scale options. So first undo, and now open the transform panel. And enable scale strokes and effects. And now again, hold the shift key and scale this. So that's fine. Next, I'd like to move these leaves. Again, choose the group selection tool and select these leaves. Hold shift key to select more leaves. So that's fine. And now choose the warp tool. And it's very important to check the options. Make a double click on the warp tool. And it's very important to uncheck detail and simplify. So now I'd like to change the brush size. Hold the alt key and click and drag your mouse. So next, hide the edges, go to view and click on hide edges. And if you like, you can scale the leaves. And next, I'd like to change the blending mode by these leaves. Change it to multiply. And like to move the flower, so select all. And now I'm going to draw some splashes and dots, so deselect all and now choose one of these brushes and green color and blending mode multiply. So this is too big, delete and again. Change the color. So if you like to change the color and move all three sliders together, hold the control key and click on one of the sliders and move. So next with red color. And another brush. Little bit darker. And with white, change the blending mode to normal. So I'm done with the flower, and I like to apply watercolor paper and the background color. So I start with watercolor paper. So before I'm going to paste the watercolor paper, I'm going to change my artboard, choose the artboard tool, and now hold the shift key. Hold the spacebar to move it, and again with the shift key. So that's fine. So this is a watercolor paper. I made it with my iPhone and real watercolor paper. So copy it and paste it into the new layer. So zoom out, hold shift key and alt key. Now I'm going to crop the image. Go to the toolbar on top and click on this button, crop image. And click apply and change the blending mode to multiply. So lock this layer and create a new layer and move the layer behind. Zoom out. So next I continue with my stamp and washes, and I'm going to use one of the last brushes. So I start with this brush and change the color to yellow like this. Change the brush size to very big. I try with 7 points. So I'd like to change the color of the layer. Make a double click on this layer and change the color. Make it darker, brown for example. So scale it. Next, with blue color. And one of the other brushes. So I try this brush. Change the stroke white a little bit. Or I try another brush. So this, so that's, and last with green color. So next I'm going to unlock my flower group and use this brush and black color and multiply to draw a new line here. So this too big, set it to 1 point. That's fine. And next I'm going to clean up my brushes. So go to the brushes panel and click on select all unused. So I've used so many brushes and now I can delete these brushes. Now we have only brushes we have used in this image. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.